Please mark your attendance. In last class, we discussed about forming numbers, right? For formation of numbers, for forming smallest number, we have to arrange the given digits in ascending order, and for making greatest number, we have to arrange the given digits in descending order. Okay, then you can see a question in page number 97. Page number 97, exercise 2.4 B. Fill in the blanks. Do you see that? Yes. What is the question? You can see some numbers and you have to write, identify that number and also find out the difference. First one, greatest three digit number and greatest two digit number. And you have to find out the difference of, what is difference? Difference is the answer by getting subtraction. Okay. And the greatest three digit number, which is the greatest three digit number? Right there. Which is the greatest three digit number? Alan Thomas, can you answer me?
999.
Yes, very good. 999. And greatest two digit number is? Which is the greatest two digit number? Amanna?
Ninety-nine.
Very good. 99 is the greatest two-digit number, and 999 is greatest three-digit number. And you are asked to find out the difference. For find out the difference, subtract 999 by 999. What is the answer, Anshi? Page number 97. Exercise 2.4 B question. Fill in the blanks. To find out the difference between some numbers. What is the difference between 999 and 99? It is 900, right? Am I correct? Yes. 900 is the difference between 999 and 99. Then second one, smallest three digit number. What is the smallest three digit number? Smallest three digit number. Okay, it is 100. Smallest three digit number is 100. Then smallest two digit number. Smallest two digit number is 10. Am I right? Yes. Then you have to find out the answer. And next one, third one. Smallest three digit number. It is 100. Already we said that 100 is the smallest three digit number. And then greatest two digit number. Greatest two digit number is 99. And you are asked to find out the difference between 100 and 99. Then fourth one. Smallest two digit number. Smallest two digit number is 10. Then greatest one digit number is 9. right? And you are asked to find out the difference. The next one, greatest two-digit number. Greatest two-digit number is 99. And smallest two-digit number is 10. And you are asked to find out the difference. Last one, greatest three-digit number. Greatest three-digit number is 999. And smallest three-digit number. Smallest three-digit number is 100. And you are asked to find out the difference. So, please fill in the answer after the class only, okay? Please find out the answer after this class. Then we have to move on to the next topic, page number 98. Page number 98. Successor and predecessor. Do you know what is successor? What is predecessor? If anybody know, please raise your hand. What is successor and what is predecessor? No. It is a new term to you, right? You are hearing this in first time. Okay. Successor means, and you are also need to find, need to study the spelling successor and predecessor. S-U-C-C-E-S-S-O-R, successor. And predecessor, P-R-E-D-E-C-E-S-S-O-R. You have to study the spelling also. Then, successor means when we add 1 to a number, when we add 1 to a number, we get the successor of that number. When we add 1 to any number, then we get the successor of that number. Understand? The number that comes just after to a number is called successor. 11 is the successor of 10. And 21 is the successor of 20. 16 is the successor of 15. 100 is the successor of 99. That means the number comes just after to a given number is called the successor of that number. How will you get a successor? By adding 1 to the given number. By adding 1 to the given number, we get the successor of that number. Okay, latecomers, please mark your attendance and take page number 98. In page number 98, you can see what would Rohit get if he adds 1 to 4326. There you can see a question. What would Rohit get if he adds 1 to 4326. What is the answer? When we add 1 to 4326, we get 4327, right? 4326 plus 1 is equal to 4327. That means 4327 comes just after 4326. Comes just after. Please underline the word comes just after. Underline the word comes just after. And we can say 4327 is the successor of 4326. In the Muhammad, what's your doubt? Page number 98. Okay. Then, second question. What would Rohit get if he subtracts 1 from 4326? What would Rohit get if he subtracts 1 from 4326? And Ifra? Okay. Then, by subtracting 1 from 4326, we get 4325, right? That means 4325 comes just before 4326. Underline the word comes just before. Underline comes just before. And please underline the words successor and predecessor in these questions. In first one, you can see 4327 is the successor of 4326 and underline the word successor. And in second one, there you can see 4325 is the predecessor of 4326 and also underline predecessor. From these two examples, we can say that successor is the number by adding 1 to a given number, and predecessor of a number is the number after subtracting 1 from a number. That means successor means the number comes just after to a number. And predecessor means the number comes just before to a number. Okay? Understand? Yes or no? Yes or no? Okay. Then, you can see some questions in exercise 2.5. Write the successor of each number. And second one, write the predecessor of each number. Can you do it as homework? Can you do it as homework? Please reply all of you, yes or no. No. Why, Aflu? Can you do it as homework? Exercise 2.5. Exercise 2.5 homework aayittu cheyyan pattu. The given numbers inde successor, predecessor. Rendu questions inde adu ezhuthan pattille. Yes or no? Yes, okay. Do it as homework. Then, our next topic. Even and odd numbers. Page number 99. Page number 99. Even and odd numbers. What is an even number and what is an odd number? Simply we can say, and then she, can you answer me what is even number?
Even, iratta, ode, atta.
Okay, even numbers are iratta sangegal and odd numbers are otta sangya. Okay, then how can we identify an even number and an odd number? If you are given a number, can you identify by looking at this number? Is it even number or odd number? Can you identify? How can we identify a number? Is that a given even number or an odd number? What is the method? Simply, we can say even numbers can be put in pairs. Even numbers can be put in pairs. That means we can divide the number by the groups of two. If you are given 10, you can divide, if you are given 10 pencils, you can divide the pencils in group of two, five groups of two, right? There you can see 6 is given in your book. 6 is given. Imagine that that are 6 chocolates. And these 6 chocolates are divided into 3 groups of 2. 2 chocolates. That means even numbers can be put in pairs. Can be divided in groups of 2. But in the case of odd numbers, all numbers have one left over when you put them in pairs. We left one thing after pairing the given number. That means if you are given 7 chocolates, example is also given there. If you are given 7 chocolates and if you put the 7 chocolates in groups of 2, you can see 3 groups there and 1 is left over without pairing. Such numbers are called odd numbers. Such numbers are called odd numbers. Okay, and it is not possible in the case of large numbers, right? We can group or we can pair the numbers only if they are small numbers. If you are given 4,624, can you pair it? Can you make groups of two? No. There is a method for identify the numbers, whether it is even number or odd number. What is the method? We can easily identify an even number by looking at the digit in the ones place. By looking at the digits in the ones place. If the digit in the ones place is 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. Or the number ends with 0, 2, 4, 6. And 8 are called even numbers. That means even numbers are ends with either 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. Understand? Yes or no? Even numbers are always ends with. Ends with means the digit in the ones place. Whether it is greater number or smaller number, if the digit in the ones place is 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, such numbers are called even numbers. You can see some example there in an orange box in your text. And also there you can see a chord. Even numbers end with 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0. There you can see some numbers. And the digits in the ones place of the given numbers are in blue color. And they are 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. These numbers are called even numbers. Or otherwise we can say even numbers can be divided by 2 without remaining. Right? Even numbers can be divided by 2 without any remaining. There will be no remainder if we divide an even number by 2. Okay? Then what about odd number? All numbers are ends with 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. That means the digit in the ones place of an odd number will be always 1 or 3 or 5 or 7 or 9. Numbers ends with 1, 3, 5, 7 or 9 are called odd number. By looking at the digit in the ones place, we can identify the number whether it is even number or odd number. Okay. The digit in the ones place is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. We can say that will be an even number. Or if the number ends with or the digit in the ones place is 1 or 3 or 5 or 7 or 9, we can say that will be an odd number. Understand? Can you follow me? Yes or no? Can you follow me? Manasilavunnundo miss parayunnathu? Undo. Even numbers, odd numbers. Endakya? Oru number inde, edengilum oru number thannal, adinte ones inde place illulla digit, onnukil 0, allengil 2, allengil 4, allengil 6, allengil 8. We can say this number, that number is an even number. Or namukku thannirikkunna oru number inde ones inde place illulla digit 1 3 5 7 9, idile edengilum oru digit anengil we can say it is an even number, sorry, odd number. Manasilayo? Or number kanda namukku manasilakkan pattuvallo even number ano odd number ano nu? Yes, there you can see some examples. Example 18. Rohan has 578 toffees. He wants to put them in packets of 2s to share with his friends. Can he make packets of 2s? What is the question? Rohan has 578 toffees. 578 toffees. He wants to put them in packets of 2s. He wants to make them in groups of 2s. Can he make packets of 2s? Chiyambattu. Who can we check that? Whether he can make the packets of 2 or not. The answer is, we can see 578 ends with 8. Right? The digit in the ones place is 8. So, The given number 578 is an even number. Right? It is an even number. All even numbers can be make or can be put in pairs. Can be make the groups of pair, groups of two. All even numbers can be put in pairs or can be make in made in two groups of two. So Rohan can make packets of twos. That is the answer. Then look at the example 9, 19. Karuna has 1885 beads. Beads ennu parnale beads muttugal alle. Okay, can she keep them in pairs? Can she keep them in pairs? Pair means the group of two. Pair means the group of two. Can she make them in pairs? There you can see 1885 ends with the digit 5. Ends with the digit 5. That means it is an odd number. 1885 is an odd number. And we know that odd number cannot be made in pairs. Odd numbers cannot be put in pairs. Why? After put in pairs, odd numbers always left one. Right? After putting in pairs, odd numbers always left one. So, there will be no pair for the last one. Thus, we can say 1885 cannot be put in pairs. ഒരു കാര്യം ശ്രദ്ധിച്ചാൽ മതി, ഈവൻ നമ്പർ ആണെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് അതിനെ പെയർ ആയിട്ട് ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ചെയ്യാം, ഓരോ പെയർ ആയിട്ട് മാറ്റാം. എന്നാൽ ഓഡ് നമ്പർ ആണെങ്കിൽ, ഓഡ് നമ്പർ മീൻസ് ദി നമ്പർ എൻഡ്സ് വിത്ത് 1 ഓർ 3 ഓർ 5 ഓർ 7 ഓർ 9. ഈവൻ നമ്പർ ആണെങ്കിൽ വി കാനോട്ട് put that number in pairs. നമുക്ക് രണ്ടെണ്ണമുള്ള ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ആയിട്ട് തിരിക്കാൻ പറ്റില്ല. വൈ? ഇവൺ നമ്പേഴ്സിനെ നമുക്കുള്ള ഗ്രൂപ്പായി തിരിച്ചാൽ ഓൾവേസ് ലെഫ്റ്റ് വൺ. വൺ എന്തായാലും ബാക്കി ഉണ്ടാവും. ആ വണ്ണിന് പെയർ ഉണ്ടാവില്ല. അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്? There is another question for your homework, page number 99. Circle the even number and cross out the odd number. You are given 16 numbers there and you are asked to circle the even numbers and cross out the odd numbers. You have to circle around even numbers and cross out across odd numbers. Okay, today you have 3 homework questions. Page number 98, exercise 2.5, there is 2 questions. Write the successor and also write the predecessor. And in exercise 2.6, page number 99, you are asked to circle the even numbers and cross out the odd numbers. These are your homework questions. Please do your homework today itself and send me before night. Okay? Okay. After completing the next one topic, Roman numbers, we can conduct an exam. Okay. In namak ee chapter la Roman numbers nu parayunna oru topic kude ullu, adu namak adutha class la complete cheyyam. അതിനുശേഷം നമുക്ക് ഒരു ക്ലാസ് ടെസ്റ്റ് വെക്കാം. റെഡിയാണോ? റെഡിയാണോ? അപ്പോ മിസ് ക്ലാസ് ടെസ്റ്റിന്റെ തലേന്ന് മാത്രമേ പറയുള്ളൂ. പഠിക്കാൻ സമയം കിട്ടിയില്ല എന്നൊന്നും പറയണ്ട. ഇത്ര വരെയുള്ള കാര്യങ്ങള് കംപ്ലീറ്റ് ആയിട്ട് ഫുള്ളായിട്ട് പഠിച്ചു വെക്കാം. ഓക്കെ. എക്സാമിന്റെ ഡേറ്റ് ഞാൻ ഇപ്പോഴേ പറയുന്നില്ല. എക്സാമിന് തൊട്ട് തലേന്ന് മാത്രമേ ഡേറ്റ് പറയൂ എക്സാം ആണെന്ന് പറയുള്ളൂ എന്താ സിനാൻ
ഹോംവർക്ക്
ഒന്നുകൂടി പറയണോ പേജ് നമ്പർ 25 സോറി പേജ് നമ്പർ 98 പേജ് നമ്പർ 98 എക്സസൈസ് 2.5 ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ എ ആൻഡ് ബി പേജ് നമ്പർ 99 എക്സസൈസ് 2.6 question a these three works are for your homework okay shall we wind up now yes do your homework and send me before night yes Sinan that's your homework question that's note that's in the last class homework okay do your homework and send me enda manna
event odinte homework unda
page number 99 exercise 2.6 question a
okay
see you in next class bye